Hi everyone, it's Jen and Belle, and we're here to do a book haul for you guys today. First, let me start off by saying that Captain Jack Sparrow and Little Bear the Pugs are running around in here, so they may make an appearance. I'm not sure. They're already causing ruckus, so I'm not sure what's going to happen, but they are up here today, so you might hear the little clicking of their nails on the floor. But, yeah, so I'm not sure if they'll be here, but at least you guys got Belle. And that's what she's looking at, in case you were wondering. Okay, so I have a short book haul for you guys. I'm just going to go ahead and get started. The first thing that I got this week was the new release of the Kingdom Keepers book, book number 5, The Shell Game. It's by Ridley Pearson, and you guys have probably seen me talk about this series before. I did post it in my top books of ever. So, yes, and what was really cool is last night, at the last minute, I found out that Ridley was actually going to be doing a book signing for this at my local Barnes & Noble. So I went, and he did, in fact, sign it for me. So you can see that there, and he was super nice. Like, really, he was so awesome. He was supposed to do a reading, but instead of doing that, he just talked about his inspiration for the 5 books and how he did research and stuff for the books. So that was so awesome, and I was so glad that I got to be there. This is a middle grade series, so there were a lot of young children there, and I was probably the oldest person there buying a book, so I'm just going to put that out there now. But I'm okay with that because this is about Disney World, and you guys know I'm like a Disney freak. So yes, I did get this, and I'm going to be doing a special vlog post all about the Kingdom Keepers books. So be on the lookout for that soon. And the next book I got is a paperback copy of Timeless by Alexandra Monier. Yeah. I've been wanting to get this book for a while, but I don't know what happened. I just ended up not getting it, and then I found out it was coming out in paperback really soon, so I just decided to wait for the paperback. It's a short book. And basically what happens is, some sort of tragedy happens in this girl's life, and she's forced to move to New York to live with her wealthy, grandparents that she'd never met. And then somehow she finds this diary that transports her back to the year 1910, and she's meeting, like, otherworldly creatures and things like that. So it's kind of like a paranormal romance, and it sounded really good, and it kind of caught my eye because it said New York City, so, and I, you know, I'm from New York, so there you have it. The next book I got is called The List. And this one is by Siobhan Vivian, and I really like the cover. I don't know what it was about this, the cover of this, but it just was like, I really wanted to get this when I had heard about it a couple of months ago. And basically, I believe, if I remember what I read about it months ago, was that a list goes out about all the girls at a school, and some girls are on the pretty list, and some girls are on the ugly list. And the main character, I think, ends up on the ugly list or something like that, and it, like, totally freaks her out or something. I don't know. But I remember when I read it, the synopsis for it, I was really excited about it. So I'm still really excited to read it. I know it was something I really wanted to read. So I got that. And the last thing that I got was Pretty Crooked. And this is by Elisa Ludwig. And I believe this is, like, on the same idea of Heist Society, I think. Maybe not. Maybe this is more like some rich girls or some girls that steal from the rich kids and give to the poor kids or something like that. I've not seen really too many reviews on it, but it was something that caught my eye. I did want to read it. It looks like a fun book to me. I don't know if it's going to be good or not. It's like plain on the front and the side. Although it does say Pretty Crooked in pretty purple letters on the side. So that's that. And I'm looking forward to reading it. I think it could be fun. Just like a quick read. It's not really that big. And I like books like about wealthy kids and stuff like that. So yeah, so I got it. And that is all that I got this week, my friends. I do know I'm getting some books for Easter, so I'll have another book haul for you guys next week. And then, I think that's it for now. But I did read two books, and I think I'm just going to combine everything into this video since it's kind of short and just tell you what I read and what I thought about it. So the first thing I read is something that basically everybody has read, and that is Anna and the French Kiss. I have to tell you guys, like, I think my expectations were just a little too high for this book because everybody was so crazy about it. And although I did like it and I think it was well written, it was nothing that, like, was super like, oh my god, this was the best book ever. I don't know, like, am I weird? Is something wrong with me because I didn't feel that way? I mean, I thought it was really good, and I liked Anna and St. Clair. I like their characters. I just felt like, I don't know, maybe I'm used to reading more adult stories, but I felt like it was so dragged on that they were not together, they were together, they had feelings for each other, what was going to happen. I felt like, at some point, I felt like the anticipation was really high, and I kept wanting to go forward and see what happened, but then it kind of like just started dipping down for me because I felt like I was going on a roller coaster, like up and down, and it was just too much. I think, like, I would have liked to have read more about them being together than just wanting to be together, if that makes sense. But I did like it. I do have Lola and the Boy Next Door, so I'm gonna read that one too. It just took me longer than I hoped to get through it because I did keep putting it down. So that's that. But I will tell you guys that I actually am, like, going through a reading slump right now. I don't know what it is, and I've seen a lot of people on YouTube saying the same thing on the book channels. It's kind of like, I'll start a book, I'm really into it, and then I don't want to read it anymore, and then I go on to something else. I'm actually, like, in the middle of reading, like, three books right now. So, I think it's just something, maybe it's a change in the weather or something like that, and people just want to be outside, not really inside reading, and it's making it hard to concentrate on the books. I don't know. That's just my guess, but I'm hoping to get out of the reading slump, obviously, because I hate being in a reading slump. That just sucks, and I don't want to read three books at the same time, but in case you're interested in what I am reading, I am reading Partials, which I actually really, really like. It's a good book. It's like a lot of action going on in it, which is like crazy because why did I put it down if I really, really like it? I don't know, but I have put it down a couple of times. And I am reading The Dressmaker, and I don't remember who that's by right now, but that is the book that I showed you in my last book haul about the Titanic, which I'm really, really liking. So I'm going to continue reading that one because I'm still into that one. I'm not really looking to, like, stop reading it. So that's that one. And what else am I reading? That's what I'm trying to show you on here. I'm reading the second book in the 50 Shades of Grey series. It's like three books in the series. And that was the other book that I read last month, 50 Shades of Grey. As I mentioned in a couple of book hauls ago, that this book is actually a self-published book, and I think it's actually very soon going to be published, if not already, in paperback. But you can get this both on the Nook and on the Kindle if you so desire. And I did mention that this is like an erotic romance book when I first talked about it, and that is what it is. I have to be honest with you, it has a great story. I mean, if you like romance stories, like, it is like the adult version of Anna and the French Kiss. Let me just put that out there. So it was kind of weird reading them both at the same time. But it is really kind of like that. Just really, really sexy times. There's a lot of sexy times. A lot. Like, every two pages, there's like really kinky, dirty, sexy times. I'm just putting it out there. And the second book, it's the same thing. It's no different. I'm only expecting it to get worse. And although I really like this book, the sexy times kind of made it, like, there was just too much sexy times for me. I don't really read those kinds of books. I'm not opposed to them. I just really don't read them. And this has a lot of really, really weird, weird sexy time things in it. So I'm not even going to dive into what they do in the book. I'm just going to say that kind of thing makes you uncomfortable. You're probably not going to want to read 50 Shades of Grey. But it is like the super most popular book right now. Women are loving it. Everybody's going online and talking about who their Christian Grey would be, and who Anna would be. Even her name is Anna in this one. Yeah, so Facebook is like booming with people that were choosing for these roles, because I believe she's already got the option for this movie, although I don't know how it's not going to be a porno. Honestly, I really don't know. They're going to have to cut out the sexy times, I guess. But yes, so 50 Shades of Grey, gave it 4 stars. I really enjoyed it, just a little too much sexy times. That's why I didn't give it 5 stars, but it's still good. So if you don't mind those kinds of things and you want a really great love romance, like like damsel in distress type thing, it's kind of like that. There's a lot of that in there. So yeah, and just for the record, my Christian Grey would be the guy who plays EJ DeMera on Days of Our Lives. He's like my dream man for everything. I pick him for everything. I always think of him in my brain, and there's a picture of him on my blog if you want to go take a look at it. If not, just look up James Scott. That's his name. He plays EJ DeMera on Days of Our Lives. He is a hottie, and he's British, and he's like my dream man besides my husband. So I'm just putting that one out there. So that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this today. I'm sorry it's been taking me a while to get back in the loop of things. It's like really hard working with the flip camera and uploading it. It takes forever, and yeah. So I'm sorry about that, but I'm going to try to be better at it, and I'm also going to try to get up a vlog this week onto Belle's Bibbidi Boutique. So that's it. So we want to thank you for watching us today. As always, I'm going to bring Belle back over so she can give a sign off. So again, thank you for watching us today. And as always, happy reading.